What is a smart skin? We've seen a lot of smart garments in the past, but we want to push beyond that, not just devices slammed into garments and clothing, but really what is intelligence and how can that connect, respond, sense, and sort of amplify human experience.
Design is about, in a way, creating problems and finding solutions for them. So we are constantly chasing our tail, but I think we are all really chasing magic. And if different worlds come together, that's when new things happen.
The Digital Skin Studio was really about challenging and questioning how far can the newest material technologies translate to fashion, apparel, wearables.
In my own work, I am quite fascinated by metamorphosis and transformation. So we call it digital skin, but actually it's really to create new connectivity through design. So connectivity within the body or connectivity to space.
This is a video of the optical fiber in one of the sleeves I built.
We formed a new class combining fashion and technology and product design with at the in Berlin and MIT architecture.
We then taught the studio, one at MIT, one in Berlin. It's the fashion world, and you know they're at the top of the field, bringing that together with the design, technology, engineering, science that MIT is known for. The students are developing their project from an early idea to prototyping to a final garment or installation.
The students at Hateve are creating surfaces that you could engage with yourself in order to increase blood circulation, for instance. Another student might be working with air around the body and how things you wear whilst riding a bike will inflate based on the way it's cut in order to lift mood, for instance, on a grey day.
So my project Fascia is about reimagining a physical therapy device. And I picked TPU as the material and 3D printing as the fabrication process. The challenge though was getting a traditional 3D printer to work with these materials. I'm trying to have it gain structure and rigidity in ways that can be not just aesthetically pleasing, but functional as well.
My project was born out of a fascination of weathering and how we can harness the materials that are washed away. We're probably all familiar with lint, which is what we remove from our dryers. And it is literally the eroded particles and bits of our clothing. So I wanted to harness those to create a material that could then shape a new garment.
Hussein and I are really excited about this course and evolving it. There's all sorts of hidden technologies and fabrication and materials that can create some kind of surprising, new, exciting way that we interact with the objects around us.
We were teaching the class together with Hussein and Skylar, and the idea was also to expand our class into a research phase.
It's very important to look at advances in materials around fashion because fashion itself is a self-referential entity. And the idea is to create objects that actually have a life of their own. You have to really understand the body to do that well. The way that the fabrics can, you know, sense or react to situations, I think it will improve our lives.
So I think that's very much an inspiration to analyze how we are collaborating with our garments and how we are activating them to be part of our behavior.
And so the teaching and the research and the lab and the project have sort of all blended together. We're really about dreaming what's possible, and we're imagining new accessories, you know, new types of fashion, new types of apparel.
Skylar has been someone incredibly refreshing to work with, to know what your limitations are and to know what the expertise of the other party is and really be excited about this. I think that makes a brilliant setting for a fantastic collaboration.
You can have these collaborations that pull you in different directions, translate what I might see in the lab and how that might get to the world. How does that change fashion in the future, and how does that change our relationship to materials, our relationship even to our own bodies, or our relationship to the environment. Like, can the emerging capabilities that we're seeing in research create a new world for fashion?